Well, good morning, children. I'm sad we aren't able to meet together, but let's not be discouraged. We can still meet as a church virtually. And as we saw last week with the contest, God is the one true God who is powerful, who can hear us and does answer our prayers. I'm going to say a prayer now before we begin. Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for your word, that we can read it and we can listen to it wherever we are. Though we miss our church family, pray that you would help us to concentrate, to listen and to love you more. Amen. I've been thinking, what kind of jobs could I not do on my own? Children, do you think that I could be a fireman? Could I drive the truck, put up the hose, put the ladder up, and then turn on the hose all by myself? What about a footballer? If I tried to play against a team all by myself, do you think I could do it? Might be exhausting. What about being a builder? Do you think I could build a whole house by myself? Might take a while. Well, in today's true story from the Bible, Elijah, who's God's prophet, thought that he was the only one left and that he couldn't carry on working alone. And so as we watch the passage today, and as we read about it, see if you can spot the answer to the following questions. Why did Elijah think he was alone? And was he really alone?
Is of the Bible, Elijah in the wilderness. This is Elijah.
Hello.
Elijah was a prophet in Israel during the reign of King Ahab. This is King Ahab.
Whatever.
He came from a line of kings who did bad things, but King Ahab was the worst of them all. King Ahab and his wife Jezebel stopped following God and worshipped a fake god called Baal. Elijah's job was to tell the people of Israel and King Ahab to stop worshiping Baal and to worship God again. But King Ahab and Jezebel didn't like what Elijah had to say, or that he proved to everyone that God was more powerful than any other god. Elijah made Jezebel so angry that she wanted to kill him. She sent him a message saying, "May the gods strike me and even kill me if by this time tomorrow I have not killed you." Elijah was terrified and ran away. He went to a town and he left his servant there.
Go on.
Then he went on alone into the wilderness. He sat down under a tree and prayed that he might die. He said, "I have had enough, Lord." Then he lay down and fell asleep. But as he was sleeping, an angel touched him and told him,
"Hi.
Get up and eat." He looked around, and there beside his head was some bread baked on hot stones and a jar of water.
Whoa!
So he ate and drank and then laid down again. The angel of the Lord came again and touched him and again said,
"Oh,
get up and eat some more, or the journey ahead will be too much for you." So he did, and it gave him the strength to get up and continue on his way to a place called Mount Sinai. Later, Elijah would do what God wanted him to and would tell the people of Israel to follow God again.
When Elijah had proved that the Lord was the one true God, the people turned from Baal and they worshipped him. But Jezebel didn't. She wanted to kill Elijah because he had shown her God to be a fake. So Elijah ran away, but he became sad and he even asked God to let him die. But an angel of the Lord was sent by God to encourage him and to give him some food. Did you spot why Elijah was sad? He thought he was the last faithful person who was left worshipping the Lord God. But he had forgotten what God had done And he had forgotten how Israel had turned back to God, had repented, and were now worshipping God. God reminded Elijah that he wasn't really alone by demonstrating his power to him. And so by the side of the cave, as we see in verse 12, it shows us that God passed by Elijah. He hid his face so as God did so. But still, Elijah felt alone. So the Lord said to him, told Elijah that he wasn't finished yet, and yet he still had work to do. He told Elijah to anoint two kings, that God would put those to death who had rejected him. And he told Elijah that there were still going to be 7,000 Israelites who were still faithful to God. He even promised a man called Elisha to help him do his work. And we're going to think, once we've done the craft, a bit more about what this passage means for us today. Worshipper of God, but that wasn't true. He needed help remembering that God is with his people. God knew how he was feeling and what he needed, because God is committed to his people. Sometimes we can feel as if we're the only Christians in our classes at school. And in some cases, that really is true. It can be hard to tell your friends about Jesus. And sometimes the easiest thing to do is just to not tell people. But like Elijah, the truth is that there are many other children like you around the world. And the Bible tells us that in heaven, there'll be a great multitude of people that cannot be counted who worship Jesus. And so like Elijah, we have a similar task to tell people about Jesus. God's plan for the world hasn't changed, and he still wants everyone to know who he is. And he calls people to repentance and faith. He calls people to turn and to worship only him, the one true God. So if we love Jesus, we need not be discouraged. If we are the only person who is a Christian in our school, instead, let's be encouraged. There are so many people who we get to tell the good news about Jesus to, and we can be the ones to go and tell them. You could share these videos, or you could read your Bible with a friend. You could tell your friends about why you love Jesus so much. And when you do this, God will always be with you through the Holy Spirit, helping you to speak.